Hi, I'm Armando from WDN. In this video, we'll take a step forward and check on how to fit your van in order to be nearly 100% independent. Back in 2012, we had a pretty poor power system that we've managed to upgrade over the years. I think we have a better solution right now, adapted to our type of travel, full-time van living while working remotely with our computers. It definitely creates a huge need to charge a lot of batteries. Solar panels aren't just for people like us that living full-time, but for anybody really. It's a great power source that keeps your batteries well charged and ready to be used. It's important for all the items inside the van that are connected to them, like fridge, lights and water pump, for example. Let's start with the batteries. At the beginning, we had two fairly small batteries. They were probably only regular 56 amp. We did some research and found that the best option on the market for this kind of vehicle was for AGM batteries. AGM stands for absorbent glass mat. This type of battery were used back in the 80s for military aircraft, vehicles and UPS to reduce weight and improve reliability. A fine fiberglass mat absorbs the sulfuric acid and makes them spill-proof, which is safe for any kind of transportation and just perfect for your van. Let's look at why I'm advising you to have this battery in your van. As I told, they're spill-proof because the matting technology. They have high specific power, low internal resistance, and are very responsive to load. They work up to a 5 times faster charge than with floated batteries. They have a better life cycle than the floated. They're good with vibration resistant because of their sandwich construction, and they work well even in cold temperatures. Let's also take a look at some limitations. They cost more than normal batteries. They're sensitive to overcharging. Their capacity has a gradual decline. They have to be stored in a charged condition, and they're not really environmental friendly. Just remember, if you don't have any proper space for the batteries in your van, try to create one in a safe and cold compartment. These batteries don't really like heat. Now that you know how to store power, let's see how you can produce some. The best and most environmental friendly is by solar power. Before this technology, big camper van usually used a small diesel generator. Not friendly, and especially if you started on Sunday at 7 a.m. near me. We started in 2012 with a small one, an 80 watt solar panel just on the roof, and it's still working well so far. We've recently bought two new ones, the Ultra Flex type, but I will show you in a later video how to install. We'll be changing our roof soon and won't install them until it's finished. So first of all, check out your van, because you need to decide where you want to put the solar panel. Of course, this is only if you want to fix it permanently on the van. You can also think about another option we used for a long time, a portable solar panel made like a suitcase. You can watch this video for more info. We recommend to not make any holes in the van, especially if you have fiberglass roof and even if it's metal. It's really not a good idea if you want to avoid infiltration inside the van, and it's also a better choice if you want to sell the van at some point. We fixed our with a super strong silicone glue and it hasn't moved for 5 years. Another possibility is fixing the panel to a rooftop rack. You can choose between two models right now that are compatible with van life. A classic one is the mono or polycrystalline with aluminium frame rigid panels. The size depends on how many cells are on the panel. Of course, the more you have, more watts it produces from the panel. These kind of panels weigh around 8-9 kilos each. If you put them on the roof, make sure that there's no shade on it as it decreases in power. In my experience, the mono is more flexible to new technology and allows more power creation for the same size as the poly. You can also choose, like we did recently, the semi-flexible solar panel. These kind of panels weigh only 1 kilo with the flexibility of a 30 degree arch and a 23.5% conversion rate. Of course, they're a bit more expensive than the older models, but it will pay off in the long term. I think this is the best option for van life, because you can also decide to not fix it on the roof, but instead easily take it out when you need power. A good tip for you is when you're fixing the panel on the roof to create a tiny space between the panel and the roof so it can breathe. If you're thinking of installing one, you will also need a solar panel charge controller. It's a small machine that regulates the voltage from the solar panel and gives exactly 12 volts to the batteries. There are a lot of models on the market. We choose our Western & Co. because it gives all the info we need on the display about the status of the solar panel. There's also a third slot where we can plug our computers directly with a simple transformer in a cigarette plug. Easy, right? If you need to charge other electrical stuff, you can also get an inverter. We just changed our from a 300 watt to 1 kilowatt, as we have more stuff that needs to be charged, and we usually do that while we drive. You simply connect it to the solar panel controller, and there you go. I think that's all you need to know about living in a van energy for now. Subscribe to our channel if you don't want to miss any of these new videos, and don't forget to catch our travel videos as well. You can also find us on Facebook and Instagram for more news, and as always, safe travels.